which we really think that we should do, you still have to adjust to all these forces. That's what we've been told. So how does that differ from what you're saying?
One thing, adjustment is one thing, compromising is one thing. Adjustment means you have a clear freedom and voluntarily you adjust other, you listen others' opinion and you adjust. That is perfectly all right. Compromising means you have no freedom, just you are forced. Please don't compromise. Even if you stand in a platform, even if you die in a platform, live an uncompromised life. I tell you, you will have a tremendous satisfaction. Just decide, I will live uncompromised life. You will see the whole thing turns topsy-turvy. As long as you run, only dog chases you. Just stand. Stand for a minute. Look at the dog. That you can chase the dog. Of course, never bite. You see, only goats are sacrificed, never lions. Have you heard of sacrifice of the lion? So become a lion, you will never be sacrificed. It is just the conscious decision to stand. I am going to be a lion. Then you will see you will never be sacrificed. As long as you behave like a goat, you will be sacrificed. When you stand up as a lion, you will never be sacrificed.
Swami, you mentioned about truth, being a professional plumber or whatever. A lot of times people, like I don't know what my...
So much of confusion has entered into the being. That is the problem. See, actually, we are led by this side, that side, that side, this side, this side, that side. We have forgotten. We have forgotten where we have started or where we are supposed to end and where we are supposed to go forward. In this type of things, only one thing can be the solution, the direct guidance of the master. Guidance of the master is only the solution, no other way. One blind man, he was walking in the Himalayas. He suddenly felt a big stick. It's not stick actually, frozen snake. Due to cold, the snake has frozen. He felt it and thought it's a stick. And he started walking with that. One enlightened master was there. He saw it and told, "Hey, what you are carrying is not a snake. Drop that, drop that." The blind man said, "No, no, no. I know it's a snake. I can feel very clearly. I know it's only stick. I can feel very clearly. I'm not going to drop." The master said, "Fool, it will, in half an hour the sun will rise. The snake will come back to the life and it will bite you. You will be killed. Drop it." The blind man asked, "I think you don't have a stick. You want me to drop so that you can pick up this stick. You can take away this stick." So that is the reason you are asking us all to do all these things. And then what do you do? The third thing, the master, out of his compassion, he just ran towards him and tried to snatch that stick, snatch that snake to throw it away. Then the blind man started beating the master. That is the same thing happens when you go for counseling also. At least I have seen many experiences. They come and ask me. If I say some parigara, people think, "Oh, I think for his own benefit he says." His own benefit he says. That is the reason I always do one thing. I just give them torch. See on your own and decide. Of course, very few who will not have that thinking, for them we give the direct guidance. That's a big problem in the counseling. When you give, when you say drop the snake, people feel, "I think you want the stick." That's why we are asking them to drop the stick. So, let you have this understanding and let it become your experience. Let you be in and become Nityananda. Thank you.